Hello dear friends, welcome in the class of TYBSC Chemistry. Today we are learning comparison between SN1 and SN2 reaction. First of all, we should understand what is meant by SN1 and SN2 reaction. Here S stands for substitution, N stands for nucleophilic, and 1 stands for unimolecular. Similarly, in case of SN2, A stands for substitution, N stands for nucleophilic, and 2 stands for bimolecular. Now, this comparison is based on the 8 criteria. The first criteria is the steps. In SN1 mechanism, there are 2 steps. First step is slow step, and second step is a fast step. In SN1 mechanism, in slow step, carbonamide is formed, and in fast step, nucleophile attacks on carbonamide to form the racemization. In case of SN2 mechanism, it takes place by only one step. In SN2 mechanism, first step is slow step, and in this step, transition state is formed, which breaks immediately to form 100% inversion of configuration. The second criteria is kinetics and rate. In case of SN1 mechanism, in slow step, only substrate takes part, and therefore rate of SN1 reaction depends upon concentration of substrate only. And it is first order reaction. In case of SN2 reaction, in slow step, both substrate as well as nucleophile takes part in slow step. So, the rate of this reaction depends upon the concentration of substrate and concentration of nucleophile. It is second order reaction. The third criteria is molecularity. In SN1 reaction, only one molecule of substrate takes part in slow step, and therefore SN1 reaction is called as unimolecular reaction. In SN2 reaction, in slow step, substrate as well as nucleophile, these two molecules takes part in slow step, and therefore SN2 reaction is called as bimolecular reaction. Now the stereochemistry. In SN1 reaction, the product obtained with racemization, because in SN1 mechanism, planar carbonamide is formed, and which is attacked by nucleophile in fast step, and we get mixture of racemization. We get the 50% inversion of configuration and 50% retention of configuration called as racemization. In case of SN2 reaction, in slow step, nucleophile attacks from the back side of the substrate and leaving group loses its position from the front side, and therefore we get 100% inversion of configuration. The third criteria is intermediate. In SN1 mechanism, carbonamide is formed as an intermediate. In SN2 mechanism, we get transition state. The sixth criteria is effect of substrate on the rate. If the steric crowding at alpha carbon atom increases, the stability of carbonamide also increases, and therefore rate of SN1 reaction also increases. In short, the tertiary substrates react by SN1 mechanism. In case of SN2 mechanism, in slow step, nucleophile attacks from the back side. If the steric crowding at alpha carbon atom increases, then back side of the substrate is completely blocked, and therefore attack of nucleophile is prevented, so rate of SN2 reaction decreases. And therefore, in case of tertiary substrate, the rate of SN2 reaction decreases. So, in case of primary substrates, the rate of SN2 reaction increases. Now, the effect of nucleophile on the rate. In SN1 mechanism, nucleophile does not take part in slow step, so rate of SN1 reaction does not depend upon the nucleophile. In SN2 reaction, nucleophile takes part in slow step, and therefore rate of SN2 reaction depends upon the nature of nucleophile. Good nucleophile increases the rate of SN2 reaction. And the last criteria is effect of solvent. The polar protic solvent increases rate of SN1 reaction, because in SN1 reaction, in slow step, carbon amine is formed and which is stabilized by polar protic solvents, and therefore rate of SN1 reaction increases in polar protic solvents. In case of SN2 reaction, polar aprotic solvent increases the rate of SN2 reaction. If the SN2 reaction is carried out in presence of polar solvent, then nucleophile gets solvated, and therefore attack of nucleophile is prevented. So rate of SN2 reaction decreases in presence of polar protic solvents. So instead of using polar protic solvent, in case of SN2 reaction, we should use the polar aprotic solvents. These polar aprotic solvents increases the rate of SN2 reaction.